Thank you. Thank you. This is fashion consumption across Europe in real time. So I hope you can see it also from the back. It's the yellow dots and the orange dots are part of 600 million visits which we generate every quarter. Consumers browsing through the assortment in the different countries on Zalando. And they tell us their interest for products. They tell us their interest for brands. They tell us their interest for certain price classes and the affinity for certain categories. But they also tell us their purchasing intent. And you see the blue dots highlighting in between. We also know not only who is searching for a certain article and browsing through the assortment, but also who is buying. And next to the interest of those consumers for the products, we also know who is behind, right? So the socio-demographic profile of those consumers, male, female, the age, but also the geographic location of those consumers. And this is very much the basis for digital marketing of today and also digital marketing of the future. And I want to give you an insight of how we do it and how we look at the industry. And So what do we do with those information, those 600 million visits which we have every quarter, 20 million active customers buying goods? Basically, we collect the data, then we have some crazy dudes which are running it through a data science brain. Yeah, don't ask me how it works, but basically they are basically aggregating the data, coming up with deep consumer profiles so that we can describe who is behind those orange and blue dots which you just have seen. Now, having 20 million active customers and addressing each of them basically through a dedicated marketing campaign doesn't really work, so we need to aggregate them, right? How do we aggregate them? We build audiences. Now, audiences is a collection of users with the same interest. And, you know, we can talk about audiences which are general, right? So male, female, age, parents, active sportsmen, and so on and so forth. But we can also build audiences which are fashion specific. Urban fashion, young fashion, just to mention two. So we can basically combine the different interests for segments and audiences which are relevant for you guys. And we can also go beyond, yeah? So we can also go into lifestyle audiences, which are not only relevant for very specific narrow fashion use cases, but also use cases for beauty, for cosmetics, but also for automotive. Now, you will ask the question, and most, I guess, many of you are not from the marketing background, so what does it help me, right? So why are you telling me this? And I think the basic message is we can help you, or this information and those audiences are the basis to sharpen and build a brand proposition, to sharpen your brand image, can help you to also develop and launch new products, but it can also help you to make your existing products more successful. And it's very simple at the end, you know, the brain and the information which we have, we can address those consumers and those audiences on Zalando, right? So identifying which audiences are relevant for a certain brand, addressing them afterwards on Zalando, but also addressing them on high quality third-party sites. We have seen Facebook here today, Instagram, but also the Vogue, wherever we find those consumers which have been on Zalando before, wherever we find them again. Now, that's quite abstract, so I brought a case maybe to illustrate in more detail and to make it more tangible. And the case is a case around G-Star. So G-Star developed a campaign jointly with Pharrell Williams, the X25 collection, most of you will know it, with the purpose and the objective to engage a younger customer group and to make basically also to drive new customer acquisition in a younger customer group. And what G-Star did is they selected Zalando as the launch partner. Why? Because we have access to what is called millennials. Yeah? So millennials is hard to define. I call everybody below 30 millennial. Yeah? And 35% of the orders on Zalando, so more than one-third of the orders on Zalando, are done by consumers which are below 30 years old. So quite attractive target group. And we have jointly came up with a campaign which combines the brain, which is the data stuff which I just talked about, but also the heart, which is more the qualitative, creative storytelling part, to achieve maximum impact and to make the brand the collection known within those consumer groups, but also to drive commercial impact of the campaign. Now, it all started with the heart, right? The more creative part of what story we want to tell in the market. And the basis was the campaign itself, which was created by Pharrell, in which he was also the model for the male part of the campaign. And we added two other components, which is the female part of the campaign, and one other creative concept, which was developed jointly with influencers to basically engage also with their audiences. And I'm going to talk a little bit more in detail of how this works. Yeah? So three creative concepts, male, female, and then basically enriched with content which was created by influencers. Now, what we did is essentially we are talking about business objectives, right? So we addressed and we brought the message across to consumers in a very targeted manner. So we selected the audiences and we brought the message across on any site, on any high quality site across the net where we could find those consumers again, right? So be it YouTube, be it Facebook, but also be it, you know, publisher sites across Europe where we could find those consumers again and where we could display the message in a highly engaging manner. We also displayed the messages on Zalando itself, right? So we have spaces on Zalando where we basically targeted those consumers, and we enriched the entire story with editorials to create even more engagement of consumers and to create really also an emotion bond to the brand, right? So editorial piece to really engage the consumer. It sounds very simple, and I went through it quite quickly, but overall the impact was for G-Star, I think, very, very satisfying and tremendous. So they built up this brand awareness for the new collection. They made the brand younger among those which we have reached, and they also sold out the key pieces on Zalando within 3 days. And I think for the consumers, it was also a great benefit. Why? Because the consumers, obviously, who are interested in those collections and who are interested in receiving an update and receiving basically being exposed to those content, were also engaged in a very targeted and highly relevant manner. Now, that was one use case where I tried to illustrate how can we deal basically with data, so the brain, and how can we combine it with the heart, the creative concept, to create impact. There's one other trend which we highly believe in, which is influencer marketing. So maybe a short question. Who follows Beyoncé on Instagram? Okay. It just have to wait, and then it's more and more. So basically, the few of you are part of a group of another 100 million consumers across the world who are following Beyoncé on Instagram. So she's talking about a lot of stuff, right? And those consumers are, and you guys are obviously actively interested. But there are many, and I guess from their perspective, many influencers which also engage with a highly relevant crowd and which are not called Beyoncé, right? And which do not have 100 million followers, but a few less. And those influencers engage with their audience in a highly relevant manner, right? They have a high credibility. If an influencer tells something like Beyoncé, they have a high credibility. We believe that this credibility can also and should also be used by fashion brands, and therefore our purpose is to connect fashion brands to those influencers. How do we do it? We have created a tool and a product which is called Collabory, yeah, with two times an A, Collabory. And the basically purpose is to, it's a little bit like Tinder, right? So we match you guys with influencers, right? So, and this in a data-driven manner, where we know that the consumers which those influencers talk with are highly interested in a certain brand. And today we have more than 2,000 influencers on the platform, and those 2,000 influencers reach more than 130 million consumers across the web, so in a highly relevant manner. So to illustrate, because I have to hurry up, I see, to illustrate this on an example, case study. So Levi's sponsored Germany's Next Topmodel on ProSieben, but the products were, you know, implicitly shown, right, during a catwalk. And what we jointly did with Levi's, we engaged 10 influencers who filmed themselves during the broadcasting of Germany's Next Topmodel, and they purchased during the show, filming themselves while purchasing during the show. Yeah? And obviously purchasing the product on Zalando, and then you can see on the right side how this impacted the traffic which we brought jointly with the influencers on Zalando, extending basically a very brand-driven campaign into a commercial impact. To summarize, we want to connect brands to consumers based on data and based on deep consumer profiles and deep consumer insights. We want to combine it with the heart, right? Because fashion, it's about emotion. Fashion, it's about telling a story. Fashion, it's about engaging with consumers. And we have created several products to do so. Thank you very much.